Mm-hmm, they're downstairs. The truck just pulled up.
There, baby. They're downstairs.
Hello.
Hello. I came right over. You see, well, I was certainly glad to hear from you people today. Life can really be so much simpler than people let it be most of the time. Well, now, with whom do I negotiate? Are you Mrs. Younger? Or your son there? Just some official papers, Sonny.
Travis, honey, you go on downstairs now, baby.
No. No, you don't, Travis. You stay right here. And you make him understand what you're doing, Walter Lee. You teach him good, like Willie Harris taught you. And you show him where our five generations done come to, son. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Me and my family. Because we are plain people, you know? We are plain people.
Yes?
I work as a chauffeur, you know? Most of my life. And my wife works in people's kitchens. And so does my mother. I mean, we are plain people.
Well, Mr. Younger,
my father, my father was a laborer all of his life.
Yes.
And my father once almost beat a man to death because this man, he called him some kind of name, you know? That's my sister. And she is gonna be a doctor. And we are very proud.
Well, we
come from a long line of proud people. The sixth generation. The sixth generation of my family in this country. And we have all thought about your offer. And we've decided to move into our house. Because my father, he earned it brick by brick. Now, we don't intend to cause no trouble or fight no causes, and we're gonna try to be good neighbors.
Then you've decided to occupy.
That's what the man said.
Well, then I appeal to you, Mrs. Younger. You're older and wiser.
I'm afraid you don't understand. My son said we was gonna move. And ain't nothing left for me to say. You know these young folks nowadays, mister. You can't hardly do a thing with them. Goodbye.
Well, I'm not final about it. There's nothing left for me to say. I sure hope you people know what you're doing.
For the sake of the moving men are here. Let's get the heck out of here.
Yeah, ain't it the truth? Ruth, put Travis's good jacket on him. Wormley, fix your tie and tuck in your shirt. You look like anybody's old hoodlum.
Lord have mercy, where's my plan?
Y'all start on down, children, start on down. Travis, y'all don't go empty-handed, don't go empty-handed. Ruth, what to do with that box of skillets in them? I want to be in charge of them myself. I'll fix us the biggest old dinner we ever had tonight.